was working in my yard when I saw a possum swinging in the foothills, and he was old and beat up and hobbling. I got a closer look and his foot was mangled. I was woken up earlier by what I thought was a cat tangle, but it was him who got it bad from the cat that night. He moved slowly down the hill when he slipped under the fence. I brought myself up, check him out, and he found a nook under the air conditioner. I pointed him out to Caroline. She crouched down and he was shaking and full of fear. And when she stood up, I asked, "Baby, why are you crying?" She said, "Because he's cute and he's down there and he's dying." Flesh was playing. Caroline drove me halfway there where I met Tony, and we drove to the city and we parked out in front of the DNA. Justin and us, we had some laughs and we took photographs backstage, and our guts were protruding and all of them. We just kept laughing and 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 laughing. Laughing and laughing and laughing and laughing and laughing and laughing. Laughing and laughing and laughing and laughing and laughing and laughing. And when Godflesh took the stage, Tony and I, we stood there floor. Drum machines hammered and feedback blazed. For a moment, everybody grew silent while Justin tuned his guitar. Church got so quiet just for a minute, and then they all soared together like a car off a cliff. They crashed and burned over and over and again they threw hard, vicious guttural beef flasks. They shook their opponent like a tough Roberto hand. Stone ran in the seventh round. Davey Moore, 216, 1983, got flesh ran around like an early Gator Rakowski. Just lunged at the mic like a hungry great white. He was on fire, giving it everything he had and killing it that night. Tearing out his spray, and it came to a screeching halt. A relentless and beautiful voice, 70 minute assault. And then he bowed down and he said, "This is like a letter tart." Holy hell, and they disappeared, and off went the crowd. And then we had pizza, and I came back to my apartment in the city. Until 4 a.m. I watched movies, and my ears were ringing. And I called Caroline out at the house. We talked about the concert and about the possum down in the nook. Foghorns, and then when I woke, Godflesh was down in LA. Tony had an open house that day, and I looked out and saw Sito and Caroline was on her way back from Lake Tahoe. I got a call from Paul Sorrentino, I'd be off to Switzerland in a week or so. Thank you. Caroline came home that night. We had dinner and watched HBO. And I'm grateful for her love and for my friends to have seen the possum walk his last walk along the ivy. Possum lost the fight. His sad black eyes, what a thing to see on a glowing Easter Sunday. But that rodent was loved, and he still thought of, and church bells rang that day. I remember hearing them in the afternoon, just as we left. He had to have heard them too.